Okay, hey you guys, I had to start with Who Run the World Girls because Baby Kemp is a girl. I'm so excited. But I do want to go ahead and dive in tonight and get after it here. So I think we'll have a couple people hopping on late. And I also know that tonight is the Bachelor finale. So props to you guys for being on team call and not watching the Bachelor. You are filling your minds with much better things. Okay, before we get started, does anybody have a new coach on with us tonight that has not gotten to introduce themselves on a team call yet? I don't think I see any new faces so far. Okay. Well, we're going to dive in, and I kind of wanted to chat tonight about tips to kind of reassessing and reigniting your business when you've maybe had a month that wasn't your month. Because I feel like we've all been there, and I've had conversations with quite a few of y'all lately of like, how do I just kind of get going again when I feel like I'm doing the things and it's not working? Because this business will work if you do. So I want to give you guys some like practical tips to what you can actually be doing to look at your business and be like, okay, if this isn't working right now, then how do I move forward and keep going and find success in this? Because I will tell you, if I have seen anything in this business, this business does not play favorites. It doesn't matter your age, your size, your race. Like, it does not matter. You can be successful in this business. I have seen women and men from across all areas of life all look different, act different, and each have found success in this business in their own way. So I kind of want to share that tonight. How you can do that. So take some notes. And if you're not having a challenging month right now, keep this in your back pocket because I promise you they will come. Y'all, each of you are entrepreneurs. And when you are an entrepreneur, you're going to have ups and downs in your business. That's just the way it goes. That's how restaurants are. That's how hairstylists are going to be. And that's the same thing for us as fitness and health coaches, is we're going to have months that we feel like we're killing it. And we're going to have months that feel a little bit harder. So keep these just kind of with you for those months that it feels a little bit harder. Okay, I want to start off with this reminder. Because I think sometimes we forget this, and it's easy to see where I'm at now, three and a half years into coaching, and think like, this is how it's always been for her. So I just want to remind you guys, I was not the coach who blew up overnight. I didn't grow my Instagram insanely fast. My income didn't replace my nursing income in a year. It's easy to look at a coach like me who's maybe hustled for 3 years and think, well, my business doesn't really look like that. I'm not as successful. And I just want you guys to know, like, I wasn't either when I was where you are. I went emerald and then I dropped because I didn't know that both your coaches had to stay active. It took me almost a year to go diamond. So like, some of you guys have gone diamond way faster than I did. The first year that we went for elite as a team, we missed it by 5 diamond coaches. That's all of the diamonds that you need to be an elite team. My first full year as a coach, I made my first full year. So I had been coaching for like a year and 4 months. I made about $13,000, which I was like excited about. But then I also remember thinking like, dang, I also worked pretty hard, like every day showing up trying to build this business, and I have $13,000 to show for it. My second full year, I made $36,000. My income had tripled, but I had also put in over 2 years. And again, I was super excited, but I was kind of like, man, 36? I thought I would have made more than that, because there was plenty of other coaches that had far higher numbers than me. And if I had looked around, I would have easily gotten discouraged and distracted. My third full year as a coach, our team was elite. And my income, you guys, was $97,000, not including my husband's account, which was another $10,000. So this was our first six-figure year, which is honestly just insane and a total blessing from the Lord. My income had tripled again. And I don't share these numbers with you guys because I think income is the most important thing in this business. I hope if you know me, you know that my heart is absolutely about helping women to know their worth and their value in Christ through health and fitness. But I share those with you because I want you to have hope and I want you to see a tangible thing of growth and what is possible and to have perspective. What if I had given up? What if I hadn't kept going to year three? If I had stopped being consistent, if I had allowed negativity to take over my mindset, if I had looked around at all the other coaches who were advancing faster than me or who had bigger teams than me or who had a prettier Instagram or whatever than me, I probably would have given up. I promise you, I am no different than you, and I promise you this business does not play favorites. It will work if you do. So I just want to put that out there because I think sometimes, you guys, when we're in our first year and a half of business, it just feels like we're just building brick by brick. And you are building brick by brick. And if you haven't read The Compound Effect yet, I need you to read it because that is the book that set my mind up to keep going and to just pump the freaking well. Just pump it and pump it and pump until that water starts flowing, because once it does, it just comes and comes. And I promise you, when you build momentum in this business, it will get easier. So if something is not working for you, I want to share some tips to get you back on track and moving forward again. Because like I said, we all have months that maybe we didn't hit the goal that we had wanted to. Maybe we get more no's than normal or whatever it might be. So I want you guys to write down six things that we're going to talk about to get yourself back on track. Okay. And fair warning, I'm going to come in a little bit hot tonight because sometimes, especially in this area, I think we need tough love. So number one, be honest with yourself. Are you doing the vital behaviors every single day? Like none of this, like, well, yeah, I'm doing it. Are you actually doing the vital behaviors every day? Every stinking day, you guys. Well, Monday through Friday. If you want to work on the weekends, that's up to you. Or did you invite some days and then get discouraged with people saying no? And then you decided to skip a couple days to kind of regroup. And then maybe you invited for a day, got a little bit discouraged, and then you kind of skipped a couple of days. Over the last month, how many days did you sit down and have a legitimate power hour? Not scrolling on Instagram, that does not count. Not looking for accounts, that does not count. Sitting down and connecting, inviting, sharing. And if you didn't watch last week's call that Meredith led, she beautifully walked through what your vital behavior should look like very simply and beautifully. So please go back and watch that. If you haven't yet, I'm not going to recap all of it, but I need you guys to be honest with yourself when you're having a tough month of, did you sit down and do the work? Because if you didn't, why would you expect to be successful? If you're not going to show up consistently, how do you expect to consistently be growing your business? And I've said this before, but I was not the girl who did massive invites every single day. Like I see coaches like Mandy Kai, who she was like, I need to grow this thing because I'm getting out of my job ASAP. And she was sending 25 to 50 invites a day. I would have drowned doing that, you guys. I would have drowned. I was doing 3 to 5 invites every single day. Every day though. You can't do small numbers and do them somewhat consistently. And I would beg you to not even do big numbers and do them sporadically, because I really think there is power in showing up for what you're doing every day, even if that means 3 to 5 people. Yes, our businesses might grow a little bit slower if we do it that way. And if you have big goals or something that you really need to get out of, or you have to get out of debt right now, then I would encourage you to buckle down and hustle and do the bigger numbers. But if your goal is long-term sustainability and growth in this business, do the 3 to 5 a day. I would rather you do that every single day without fail than try to do 10 to 20 invites a couple of days and then wear yourself out. So be honest with yourself. Are you doing the vital behaviors every day? And there was a really good quote that Paige actually shared from her personal development book that said, "So often we pretend we've made a decision, but when what we've really done is signed up to try until it gets uncomfortable." So if you are here and you have made a decision that you want something better for your family, that you want to make an impact in other women's lives, that you are passionate about health and fitness, then make the decision to be here. Make the decision to show up for your business daily. Don't sign up for something and try until it gets uncomfortable, because you might as well quit now, because I guarantee you this business will get uncomfortable at times. Every job does, right? Like, there's not going to be a job where you're just high on it every single day. There's going to be hard moments when someone doesn't say no, or someone doesn't say yes to you that you were excited about, whatever it might be. So if what you've really done is sign up until it gets uncomfortable, then you're bound to quit. So make the decision to be here and to be here for what you initially signed up for. So number two, are you doing personal development? This is part of your vital behaviors, and I guarantee more than half of you guys are skipping it. Are you doing personal development? You guys, this is what will keep you going and give you inspiration. People are going to tell you no, I promise. And you're going to hear no way more than you hear yes. And that's okay. That's literally the law of averages when it comes to a business like this. You can expect about 1 in 10 people to say yes to joining you. That's normal. It's okay. Like, no, if you have 1 in 10 people saying yes to you, that you're rocking it. We are not here to force people into this journey with us. We are here to find those people who will thrive with what we have to offer. And that's a lot of people, you guys. 10 to 15 minutes a day dedicated to growing mentally in your business. I promise you will be a game changer. And y'all, I know I've shared this before too, but when I started as a new coach, I initially was doing my personal development like as my quiet time, my Bible study, because yes, you are personally developing yourself spiritually, but I would challenge you, don't compromise that, but adding in 10 to 15 minutes of personal business development. They're very different, and it made a big difference in my business. So if you're not doing one, again, the compound effect, the slight edge, Meredith had said one last week, I think it's called So a Man Thinketh. Ooh, sorry, Meredith, if I just got that wrong. Get something and do it daily. I don't even like to read, so I do audiobooks. Whatever it's going to work for you, but do something that you're going to stick with. And if you don't like the personal development you're doing, you need a new one. This should be something that breathes life and excitement into you. And so if you've got one that feels like a chore to do every day, you're reading the wrong personal development. Okay, number three, are you doing a program start to finish and sharing the heck out of it? Y'all, this is like foundational to our business. This is what has been one of the like founding building blocks to growing my business, is I have done a program start to finish since the day I signed up. Not just sharing your sample moves, like, are you bringing people on the journey with you? Sharing what you're learning along the way, sharing what's helping you on the meal plan, how you're meal prepping, recipes that you're currently obsessed with. You guys, I cannot tell you how many times I've put that chicken salad on my story. And if I put it on there once, people probably wouldn't have even taken notice to it. But if I put it on there like 500 times, now I have a ton of people tagging me in it, because if I'm sharing it like crazy, they realize that I must think it's good. So I need you to share the heck out of your journey so that people will take notice and know that it's making a difference in your life. Make your followers become your fans. Make them root for you. So this is not about showing up and being salesy on your story and being salesy about the program that you're doing. This is about showing up and showing people that you are committed, you are excited, and that they can do this too. How freaking cool that through posting our workouts and talking about what's going well in our journey or what's not going well, that we get to inspire other people that they can change their lives doing something as simple as 20 to 30 minutes of exercise a day. That is such a gift, you guys. Don't miss out on that. In my first program postpartum, I did Morning Meltdown 100, and I shared every single workout, y'all, like day one to day 100, so religiously. I shared how frustrated I was with my lack of core strength on certain days, and I shared how I was feeling super strong on other days. I just brought people on the journey with me, and by day 100, everybody who had been watching was celebrating with me. It was so fun. It was really fun, and I cried. And that following month when it released, I hit my highest success club ever, almost success club 100. That's 50 new people that I signed up that following month just from sharing my journey, right? Like, these people weren't necessarily joining me along the way per se. Some of them were, but when I finished and they had seen the whole thing, they believed in themselves because they had watched me do it. So along those lines, I need you guys getting results. You have to. You have to be committed to your own journey and to the meal plan. Because if we're not committed, how can we expect our clients and challengers to be committed? We are walking proof. You guys, you are a billboard for your business that these programs work. So if you're slacking in your own journey right now, you're actually shooting your business in the foot. Use coaching as your accountability and do it for yourself. Do it for your business. Do it for those that are watching you that you're getting to inspire. And if you're brand new and you're like, I don't have before and afters yet, or I'm just starting my first program, what's great is take your before pictures, and you can kind of either post your before pictures or post them with like kind of something hiding them. And what another thing that I did was sharing the test group before and after pictures. So if you're like hopping on your story, talking about how you're really excited for this new program that you're about to do, and you're excited for your own journey and the change that's about to happen, I would share the test group before and after photos. And all you have to do is Google them. Dana asked us the other day, you don't have to like give credit to whoever's photo it is. The ones that Beachbody has put out, they will have their own branding on it. But I was in a test group and we all just share our photos and they're kind of free reign. Like, we're like, have at it, share away. So you can Google like Morning Meltdown 100 test group photos. A zillion will pop up. So share those. And it's so cool to share like even different body types, because obviously not everybody following me has the same body as I do. And so it's fun for them to see other people who are also having results from these programs and having life change too. So utilize those. Those have been a big help in me advertising and inviting to getting people plugged into my group. But please do yourself a favor and be committed to your own journey. You're going to have so much more joy doing this business when you feel like you're thriving in your fitness journey. So if you need to like throw out the box of Oreos tonight, throw it out and get on the meal plan and get on a program and start getting results. Okay. Number four, how are you inviting? Because there's a difference between inviting and doing it in a way that's going to be conducive to business. We can copy paste invites and throw them out there. You guys, like, I guarantee all of us have gotten invites from other companies at some point where you're like, I'm not even responding to that. I don't know you. That you clearly just copy pasted that and didn't even look at my profile. Why would you send me that? So there's a difference between just copy and pasting an invite to someone just to say I sent an invite and doing so intentionally. It doesn't count if all you're doing is copying, pasting, okay? If your invite isn't working right now, I need you to take a hard and fast look at it and objectively ask yourself if it needs to change. You guys, inviting is constantly changing. Over the course of 3 years, my invite has changed so many times just as social media changes and kind of as certain people start all using the same invite, somebody will get on the national wake-up call and be like, this is how I'm inviting and it's working super well. And then suddenly half the network is sending the same invitation and everybody's getting the same invite. Then, you know, we start looking like one of those copy-pasted messages. So constantly be evaluating your invite. If your invite stops working, it's not because you're a bad coach. It's not because you're a failure. If something's not working, we just change it. We just adjust and we figure it out again and we keep going. So look at this first. Who are you inviting? Have you ever talked to these people before? Are you spending time building relationships with them? If not, you need to start dedicating some time to cultivating these relationships. I want you guys to be so annoyingly friendly on other people's pages that they have to follow you back and they want to be your Instagram friend. I was just like chuckling at myself preparing for this call and reading through some of the messages that people had just commented on my post about having a girl. You guys, some of these people I do not know. Like, I've never met them in real life. All we are is Instagram friends. And yet they are so pumped that I'm having a girl. And I feel like I know them just because I have like commented on all their Instagram stuff. And we have become friends because I was annoying about commenting on their pictures. And so they followed me back and now they love following my journey. So be annoying. Notice people. Take interest in their life. This is another area, you guys, that we get to literally be like the hands and feet of Jesus, of investing in people's lives through being Instagram friends. Like, that is actually super cool. So I know it takes a little bit of time, but set a timer, 10, 15 minutes, and just invest in building and cultivating relationships. Because the last thing we want is to just follow people and then hope that they follow us back, or when they do, just shoot them an invite, right? Like, then they're going to think all you followed me for was like to shoot me an invite and make a dollar off of me, which we hope they do join our group. But more than that, we hope to just invest in their lives, right? Okay, so be that annoying person that they have to be your Instagram friend because they just love you. Number two, go back to your warm market. Sorry, this is number two in point number four. We're talking inviting. Go back to your warm market. You guys, this is something I am so challenged in like my own life right now, because I look around and I'm like, not every woman in my neighborhood is in my group. Not every female in my small group from church is doing my group. There are so many people in my immediate circle who I can still be inviting and I can still be like reaching out to. Even if there's someone who had said no in the first year, that was 2-3 years ago. They have been watching my journey since then, and maybe they're waiting for me to invite them in because they feel awkward. That was me. I felt so awkward. I would have never said anything to my coach who I went to high school with. And she invited me and I was so glad that she did. So I need you to go back to your warm market. And here's one thing that I did. My entire Facebook friends list. Because I feel like on Instagram, sometimes we do connect with people that we don't necessarily know, but Facebook tends to be a little bit more intimate. So here's your challenge. I want you to open up your Facebook friends list. And if your target market is male and female, great. Mine is females. So every single woman that is on my list, regardless of age, regardless of life stage, I sent them an invite. And I found myself being very tempted to skip over some people, thinking like, well, they already do this, or they probably wouldn't be interested, or they're not big on social media. And that's not fair. Because why would I say no for somebody when they haven't said no themselves. At least give them the chance to say no, or say like, hey, thanks so much for thinking of me, like, not the right time. That's okay. But if I don't even give them the opportunity to say yes, there's never going to be a yes from them. So go to your Facebook friends list and send every single person that is in your market, whether that's women or men and women, an invite. And you guys, this doesn't have to be like a super weird scripted invite. I want you to just tell them that you're running a group. So this is something like I would say, I'm just going to tell them that I'm running a group for women who want to be accountable in their health and fitness journey. I'm going to genuinely tell them how excited I am and that I'd love to do it alongside them. And that I would love to have their support and getting it up and running, especially if you're a new coach, you guys, ask people to help you get it up and running. I would love to do that for one of my good friends. And I shared a video on our team page the other day about how my friend had started Beauty Counter, and I would have never bought that from somebody else. But because she was my good friend from college, I was more than happy to support her. So don't underestimate the people that love you. Ask them to support you. And truly be so excited and just genuine about what you're doing and why you're excited about it. Don't feel like you have to send them a weirdo script from our team page. Like, just be yourself. And another good practice that I know we've shared before is like, say your invite out loud. And if it feels weird when you say it, it's probably going to be weird to send it. So maybe even better, send a video of yourself, like a 10-second video that they can watch, or a voice message so they can actually see like you're really excited and you thought of them and you'd love to have them on this journey with you. Another thing you're inviting, I want you guys to think about, that I have been kind of thinking a lot lately, is cut out the typical phrases. And again, I think this is because like someone will go on the national wake-up call and share their invite and suddenly everybody is using it. So this is just kind of a thought that I have been having. So take it with a grain of salt. But invites, like I said, are forever changing. And maybe phrases like virtual boot camp, or I can't even think of the other words that we use right now. Maybe those phrases aren't working anymore. Right? Like maybe so many people are using like virtual bootcamp that when we send that, they're like, oh, you just want to sign me up for something. And they can't see past that. Like they can't see the value in it because they get stuck on maybe having heard that from somebody else who genuinely didn't want to help them and just wanted to make a dollar off of them. So if you have phrases like that, or phrases that a lot of other coaches are using in your invite, maybe consider changing it up and using something different. Switch it up if you're not getting good responses from things. So maybe try your invite for a week, see how responses are going. And if you're not getting a good turnaround of responses, then one, go back to points 1 through 3. And two, change up your invite that next week and try something new and see how it goes that week. So I want you guys to think, like, what would you actually say to someone that you're wanting to join who is your good friend? That's all we're going to do. Okay, number 5, are you guys genuinely pumped about what you're doing? Because if you're not, people are going to sniff you out real fast. I need you to get on your stories and actually be hype about what you get to do as a coach. Your own journey that you're on and how you get to help other people, people need to feel your excitement. Quit being a robot and just posting graphics that you see other people posting, other coaches posting. Be you and be excited. You guys, energy is so contagious. I think about this all the time when I was a camp counselor. If I was so pumped about a theme night that we were doing, my little high school campers were freaking pumped about the dorkiest theme nights that we were doing. So if you guys are excited about the program that you're about to do, you better get on your story and share why you're so excited for that. Stumble over your words, get on and talk, have no makeup on, like whatever, be yourself and let people feel that excitement as opposed to just posting wording. Like let people see you and feel how pumped you are. I will always get on when I'm doing a new invite to a program. Of course, I'm doing behind the scenes invite every day. Right now I'm talking about like a public invite. I will get on my stories and share why I'm so excited about this specific program that we're about to start. So right now my group is doing Transform 20 and the Lift 4 Hybrid, which were the two programs that I did last time I was pregnant. So I got on my story and shared that. This is why I'm so excited. It helped me have a healthy pregnancy last time, and I felt really good. So I'm planning on feeling really good again this time. And I smile, I laugh. Keegan walks in the background half the time and we laugh together. Like, let people see how excited you are and that you're not a robot. But you're not. And you guys are great coaches and excited to do this. So let people feel that. Energy is so contagious. And you know what's funny, y'all, is I will look back on some of my posts from, you know, my first 6 months, my first year as a coach, and I just kind of laugh at myself because they were so, like, they're just silly. Like, something I would never post now, but it was just like, day three, quarter four, had so much fun with my workout, whatever, saying something encouraging, and I would just post my little sweaty selfie in our apartment gym. And while it looks so silly now, I was just so genuinely excited to be sharing the program that I was doing every day. People didn't think I was silly. People were cheering me on and people were joining me. Like, I kind of look back and I'm like, why are people joining me? This is weird. But I was being myself and I was learning and growing as a coach and learning how it was best for me to share my story and kind of growing with social media. So don't feel like you have to be perfect to show up on social media. You will learn as you go. You're going to fail forward. You're going to see what works, maybe what didn't work, but I need you to just fail forward and just be yourself. Be excited. And I really was that. I was consistently excited about what I was doing. And so people joined me. They couldn't help it. They just had to join. Okay. So number six, last thing. This, well, they're all, 1 through 5 are all very important, but I need you guys to hear this. Put your blinders on. You have got to keep your vision at the forefront of your mind. You cannot constantly look around you at other coaches and compare yourself. I promise you that will suck the joy out of this business so fast. It will make you focus on the areas that you're falling short, quote unquote, falling short, rather than all of the areas that God is blessing you in this business and that he is working in and through you. You have to focus on every single win, every single blessing, even if they're coming at different paces than other coaches. If I had looked around at other coaches and compared my journey to theirs, I never would have made it to a six-figure year. I wouldn't have, because there were so many other people going faster than me. So many other people whose Instagrams were quote unquote better than mine. And I just kept my blinders on. I knew what I was hoping to achieve. I knew my mission and passion to help other women. And I knew if I just kept going, I was gonna get there. So I need you to put your blinders on and quit comparing. Focus on your business. Focus on the blessings that are coming into your life and that you're able to give to other people. No matter if that's you earn 6 figures in your first year, great. I hope you do, and I hope you use it to bless other people. Or if it takes you 5 years. If you guys look at Emily Favre, who was, I think, the number 3 coach last year, if you look at her income progression, for 5 years, she sat at the same income, making about $500 a week. And on her 6th year, she made 20 grand in a month. She blew up and went 15 star like in no time. It was insane. So stick around and keep evaluating your business in these areas and make tweaks and changes where you need to. And know that God has called you into coaching and into this purpose on purpose. And don't doubt that. He doesn't really make mistakes, so I choose to trust that. Okay, last thing I want to leave you guys with is this. You guys know this is one of my favorite quotes, and I'm going to put it in the chat so you guys can all put it on your mirrors because it needs it. This is something I like live by in my business, and it's from my OG favorite book. It says, what's easy to do is also easy not to do. The magic is not in the complexity of the task, not the test, the task. Coaching, you guys, what we do every day is not very complex. We do the vital behaviors. That's what we do. But the magic is doing the simple things repeatedly and long enough to experience the magic of the compound effect. Let this be your mantra for your business, because it's easy to show up for your power hour, and it's also really easy to sleep in and skip that hour. It's easy to run a challenge group, but it's also easy to like not check in on them for a day. So don't opt for the easy swapping out of things. Like, opt in for showing up daily and doing the things that we need to do to keep moving our business forward, and trust the process and keep your blinders on. Okay, those are your six things I need you guys to focus on when something's not working in your business to reevaluate. Do you guys have any questions about how to do that? Or maybe anything specifically in your current business that needs a little pump up? Parker Lee, are you raising your hand?
She needs lots of help. She's very fussy, so I apologize. But I do have something to say really quickly. I was really thinking about the results piece. And if we think about it, like, you know, the people that sell toothpaste, I don't know if you guys know anyone that sells toothpaste, but that's like a thing. And like, if their teeth were still yellow, you would never buy that toothpaste. I just thought about that. Like, we have to get good results or no one's going to want to join us. No one's going to want to spend $170 on a challenge pack if we're not getting results. So you would not buy toothpaste from a person with yellow teeth.
True that. And you guys, when I say like get results, this doesn't have to be like all of a sudden you have a six pack after 1 6-week program. Like, show people the journey, show people the process. And, you know, I just had this conversation with another coach on our team. Like, if you're not about posting pictures with your shirt off, show them how your shoulders are growing. Show them how your back is getting stronger. Show them how your biceps are getting stronger. Show them these things, or like side-by-side videos of your burpees, how you've improved. There's ways to show results that doesn't necessarily have to be a sports bra and shorts if that's not your jam. So just get creative with it, but people need to see that what you're doing can work for them. And we get to be walking billboards for that. Yes, Dana, me too. How do you balance it with just jumping into the invite? So if someone is engaging in conversation with me, and like clearly they feel comfortable, or they ask a question about something, kind of talking about people that maybe I don't know from real life. At that point, I want to make sure I have at least 5 to 6 back and forth with them before I say something like, hey, I'm so sorry I hadn't thought to invite you yet, but I run an accountability group for women working towards their health and fitness goals. It would be so fun to have you part of that. I'm happy to send you info if you'd like. That little like transitional invite message has worked so well for me, because I'm really there to build the relationship. And once we go back and forth a while, I'm just like, hey, I'm so sorry I hadn't even invited you yet. Like, that was rude. This is what I do. Like, this is what I'm passionate about. Of course I'm going to invite you into something I'm passionate about. And I feel like it doesn't come across as like icky, you know? So that has worked really well. If it's people that I like went to high school with or something like that, I will usually jump straight into the invite, because for the most part, they have like seen what I'm doing, and it almost feels like it would be weird to just like strike up a conversation and they're like, I know you're going to invite me to something. So I will make sure that I notice something about them first. Like, hey, I saw you just moved to Texas. That's so cool. I used to live in Dallas. And then I'll send them an invite. So I will do a connecting piece, a reconnecting bit first, that's just like, hey, I haven't seen you in forever. So cool to see that you're doing well. I was thinking about you and thought it would be, you know, fun to do this together. Did that help? Okay. Any other thoughts or questions? Okay. We are gonna be done for the night. You guys, if you have specific things that you want training on in our team calls, either text me or tag me in the team page, because I'd love to help you guys in the specific areas that you're wanting to grow. So just let me know if there's something specific you guys want a team call on, and we will of course do it. Let's do boomerang real quick and then we'll head out. If you guys haven't watched the National Wake Up Call from the last 3 weeks, they've been really good. All right, baby girl Kemp on three. 1, 2, 3. Have a great night, you guys. Thanks for hopping on, and let's make it a killer week.